Dear all, welcome back. Today we will see library classes. In Java, there are different type of classes, and mainly there are two type of classes we will specify. First one is predefined classes or library classes, and second one is user defined classes. Predefined classes or library classes means some classes available with Java system to provide support to the Java programmer to develop their programs. These classes are called library classes. And second one is user defined classes. A class which is created by us, that means user, is known as user defined classes or custom classes. Benefits of using library classes. What are the advantages of using library classes? First one is, it reduces the size of your class file. That means code can be extracted and moved elsewhere where it don't disturb anyone. That means you can store the classes separately in separate file. Cleaner API, application program interface, since you can't leak internal fields. Third one, you can test your library independent of your application. If the library is with no errors, then the bug must be in your app or application. Reduces test and debugging time. Fourth one is, you can reuse a library or same function in several projects without writing much code. Fifth one, helpful to keep program code in short, also helpful to hide your program methodology. So what is the environment of Java? How it will be like? The first thing is, you can see on the screen, there is JDK. Whole thing we will call it as a JDK, Java Development Kit. It contains two more things. One is JRE, another one is Application Development Tools. And the JRE contains Java libraries and JVM, Java Virtual Machine. And JRE means Java Runtime Environment. When we write one Java source program, we will give it to JDK. And the first part of JDK is Java compiler. By that we will compile the Java source program. Then it creates the bytecode, and after that we will use Java interpreter to run that thing. If you are a developer, you may have Java compiler interpreter, by that you can compile and you can run. But if you are not a developer, then you need Java runtime environment or JRE in your computer. Otherwise, running Java program is not possible. And this JRE, Java Library and JVM, this Java Virtual Machine, which is essential or needed in the user's computer to run Java program. What is JRE? It is one environment needed to run Java programs. Developer needs JDK, but the user who want to make use of Java applications needs JRE. So, in mobile, to run Java related app, we need JRE. Even in computers, to run Java based application, we need Java Runtime Environment or JRE. What is JVM? JVM is short form of Java Virtual Machine. It is part of JRE, as we see in the last slide. It converts bytecode into machine language. It is also called runtime engine. Remember, JVM is different compared to your compiler. Compiler converts source program into bytecode, but the JVM converts bytecode into machine understandable language. The available library classes. The first one is java.io, which is used for input and output operations, and which we will used to take input-output functions. Java.lang, Java.lang, used for character and string operations. Java.awt, that is called as Abstract Window Toolkit, used for Windows type of interface. Java.util, utility classes, used for developing utility programs. Java.applet, used for applet programming. Java.net, used for network communication. Java.math, used for various mathematical calculations, like to find the power, maybe 2 raised to 4, maybe square root, maybe sine, cosine, etc. There are many number of library functions, but some we will use more commonly. Java.io, Java.lang, and Java.math in application programming, and Java.awt, Java.applet in applet programming. The first we will see input-output operations in Java, and along with that you will learn Java I/O library. There are two methods to input values from the user. The first one is using readLine function of data input stream class available in java.io class. And in programs we will take import java.io.dataInputStream semicolon to import that Java library. That means this readLine function is in data input stream. So we will create the object of it by using data input stream dis is equal to new data input stream system.in. Here you can see data input stream is a class of Java IO library. DIS is an object or instance of that class. New is to create object in a dynamic way. Data input stream system.in. We are passing system.in as a parameter and it represents keyboard. System.in is an input stream which is typically connected to keyboard. In applications with GUI or GUI, the input to the application is given through the GUI. A is equal to integer.parseInt, dIn.readLine. This is one method how we will take the input. We took input from the keyboard, but when we take the input, it will be in a character form. We are converting that one into integer by using autoboxing system, that is integer.parseInt, dIn.readLine. Same way, b is equal to float.value of dIn.readLine. There are two methods to input values from the user. First one, as we seen in the last screen, data input stream dis is equal to new data input stream system.in semicolon. This stream class is not so compatible method in the recent version of Java. So it's better you replace this line of code with the another stream class, that is buffered reader, br is equal to new buffered reader, new input stream reader system.in. Since if you use the data input stream, it will show one warning message at the time of compilation. To avoid that thing, we will use buffered reader. You will see that thing in the example. So in this program, we can see the first statement is import, import java.io.dataInputStream, and this we have taken to take the input. And there is a class input 11, public static void main string args, data input stream dis equal to new data input stream system.in. We have created instance for the keyboard using data input stream class. Now dis is an object, by that we can take methods or functions related to input operation. Float number 1, comma number 2. We took two variable of type float. Try. System.out.println enter one float value. Number 1 is equal to float.value of dis.readline. Enter another float value. Number 2 is equal to float.value of dis.readline. Float number 3 is equal to number 1 plus number 2. Then the result is equal to plus number 3. And here you can see we took system.out.println result is equal to plus number 3. Since in println we can take only the string type of values. So we have used plus as a concatenation operator to combine this float type of value with string. So result is equal to plus number 3. Then we took try block. Since when we are taking the stream classes, data input stream, it throws one exception. That means it throws one error. And to avoid that error, we have taken try block. And what this try block will do, like try block will catch hold of that error, whatever the error it creates, this object creates in this dis.read line, it will catch hold of that error and it will throw out. And this catch block we took to catch that error, and when it will catch the error, we can display some messages, relevant messages for understanding purpose. So I took system.out.println, there may be arithmetic error. Now we will save this program. I'll save, and then we will go to command prompt. Java C input 11.java. Okay, now you can see it is compiled, but there are some warnings. You can run the program. You can see dir input 11.star. So it's already compiled with the class file, with the bytecode. We can run that program. Java input 11. Enter one float value. Enter another float value. So it displays the result. And we can avoid this warning by using one more class. That is BufferedReader br is equal to new BufferedReader new input stream reader system.in. That means we have to replace this one with this class. Then it will not show the warning. Just we will check it out. We will change BufferedReader. BufferedReader B or DIS is equal to new BufferedReader. New input stream reader system.in. Now save this program. Now run again. Java. It will show error. So error is cannot find symbol BufferedReader. So we have to take java.io.BufferedReader. Otherwise you can take star asterisk symbol. That means take all the classes of IO library. Now we will compile. Java C input 11.java. Now it is compiled with no error. Even there are no warnings, just run the program. Okay. This is one method. There is another method to input the values from the keyboard. That is by using scanner class of java.util. In that there is function called next. By that we can input the values. And for that we will take the command import java.util.scanner. Then the advantage of the scanner class is it will not throw any errors or exceptions. That means no necessity of taking try block. Without taking try block, we can input the values. Scanner input is equal to new scanner system.in is the command to create the object. So scanner is a class of java.util library. Input is one object. New is to create object in dynamic way. Scanner system.in, we are passing system.in as a parameter. It represents the keyboard. And how we will take like string name is equal to input.next or string name is equal to input.nextLine. The two functions we can take. Float b is equal to float.value of input.next. Int c is equal to input.nextInt. Now we will see one example how this concept works. In this program, import java.util.*. Here we took asterisk, that is star, to take all the classes of util library. Then public class input 1, public static void main string args, scanner s capital, scanner s is equal to new scanner system.in semicolon, float number 1 comma number 2. Then system.out.println enter one float value with no try block or catch block. Directly we took the values. Number 1 is equal to float.value of s.next. Same way number 2 is equal to float.value of s.next. Then float r is equal to number 1 plus number 2 system.out.println result is equal to plus r. Now we will save this program. We will run by taking javac input1.java. Now it's compiled. Run this program java input1. Enter one float value. Okay, now it's in simplified way. Without any try block, we can input the values by using scanner class. We will see one more program. In that, directly we will take one more method of scanner class. So here you can see number 4 is equal to s.nextInt. NextInt is a method to take integer values, s.nextInt. Commonly when you take next or next line, it will be of type character or string. But if you take nextInt directly, it will take integer value. No necessity of taking integer.parseInt. Directly we can use this one. Number 4 is equal to s.nextInt. Number 5 is equal to s.nextInt. R is equal to number 4 plus number 5. Then result is equal to plus r. So we will save this program and we will run. Input 2.java. We will run this one. Java input 2. Enter one integer value. We can see the result.
Thank you, friends. Till now, we have seen manual method of making programming. Now onwards, we will see the IDEs. As you know, there are so many IDEs available for Java, and that all things I will show one by one. Maybe first BlueJ, and then IntelliJ, then Eclipse, all those things how we can use to write the programs. That we will see in the next class. Thank you. Come back again.